ट्रिपल कॉलम कैश बुक, ट्रिपल कॉलम कैश बुक मीन्स देर आर थ्री कॉलम्स, वन इज कैश, अदर वन इज बैंक, अदर वन इज डिस्काउंट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड ट्रिपल कॉलम कैश बुक. कैश इज द रियल अकाउंट, वाट कम्स इन डेबिट. कैश वच्चिनप्पुडु डेबिट लो रायाली. What goes out credit? Cash పోయినట్లయితే credit చేయాలి. When cash is comes into business, it will be debited. When cash is going outside, it will be credited as per the real account. When you are preparing the cash column, we must remember and real account principle. Next, bank is personal account. So, debit the receiver, credit the giver. When bank is receiving the cash and it must be debited. When bank is giving cash and payment made by check, whatever it may be, it is credit side. Discount is nominal account. All losses, expenses, debit. All incomes and profits, credit. So, discount allowed is and debit side. Discount received is credit side. This is remember one thing. Next, in triple column cash book, cash receipts recorded in cash column debit side. Compulsory, if is cash receipt, it must be recorded in cash column only on debit side. Suppose cash payments recorded in cash column credit side. Cash payments, it must be recorded on credit side cash column only. This is the first point. Second one, check receipts in bank column debit side. If any check receipts through sale of assets, sale of goods, received from the others, whatever it may be, income received in form of check, whatever it may be, it must be and debit side in bank column. It must be remember one thing. Check issued or check payments in bank column debit credit side. Check issued to others, payment made by check, payment through check, any expenses through check, whatever it may be, purchases through check, and it must be in bank column credit side. It is remember one thing. Next, discount allowed, debit side, discount received, credit side, as per the principal nominal account, all expenses, losses, debit. So, discount allowed must be debit side. All incomes and profits, credits. So, here, discount received is must be on credit side. It must be remember and one. Next one, contra entries means one transaction record in triple column cash book, both in both sides, one date, the transaction is called contra entry. Remember one thing, some of the transactions record on the debit side as well as credit side simultaneously, one date. So that type of transactions is called contra entries. Contra means opposite. It must be recorded on the debit side as well as credit side. The transactions is called contra entry transactions. The contra entry must be recorded both the side, debit side as well as credit side. Sometimes and debit side in cash column, sometimes credit side in bank column, sometimes and debit side in cash column and credit side in bank column, whatever it may be. And this is transactions is called contra entries. Next, the contra entries are, these are the contra entry transactions and newly opened account. Newly opened account and these are the following transactions are contra entry transactions. Newly opened account with bank, cash deposited with bank, कैश विड्रॉन फ्रॉम बैंक फॉर ऑफिस यूज, चेक रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम कस्टमर डिपॉजिटेड नेक्स्ट डे, चेक डिपॉजिटेड एंड डिसऑनर्ड, दीज आर द ट्रांजेक्शन्स कॉन्ट्रा एंट्रीज. दीज ट्रांजेक्शन्स मस्ट बी रिकॉर्ड डेबिट साइड एज वेल एज क्रेडिट साइड साइमल्टेनियसली और ऑन द सेम डे वाट एवर इट मे बी. नेक्स्ट, सो हाउ टू रिकॉर्ड दिस ट्रांजेक्शन्स इन ट्रिपल कॉलम कैश बुक. Newly opened account with bank, you must record on the debit side as a cash to cash amount in bank column. Amount in bank column. Suppose here mention cash account, amount will bank column. It must be remember one thing. Suppose the same date by bank. Amount in cash column. Amount in cash column credit side. So the same transaction must be recorded on the debit side as well as credit side. Debit side to cash, amount in bank column. Credit side by bank, amount in cash column. It must be remembered. Next, cash deposited with bank. Cash deposited with bank, cash paid into bank and cash sent to bank, whatever it may be, all are and the same, the cash deposited with the bank. So this I am also, and you have to record on the debit side, record as cash to cash, amount in bank column, amount in bank column. It must be remember. Next, the same transaction on the same day, credit side, but you have to record as by bank, amount in cash column, amount in cash column. And in another way, suppose you have to record cash amount in bank column, suppose you have to record bank amount in cash column, means opposite directions. Next, cash withdrawn from bank for office use. So you have to write this way on the debit side, record as to bank, amount in cash column. This is and reverse to previous transaction, reverse to previous transaction. Debit side to bank account, amount in cash column, credit side and write as by cash, amount in bank column. This must be remember. Check received from customers, this is split into two parts, A another one B. This is the B. They are split into two parts. When the received check from customers and says deposited next day or next day or next week or next 2-3 days, whatever it may be, when receiving check from customers, it must be recorded as to customer account, debit side amount in cash column. Amount in cash column. When they says the above check is deposited into bank, above check is deposited into bank, so then option B, write to cash account, amount in bank column, amount in bank column. Next, credit side, write by bank, amount credit side, amount in cash column, amount in cash column. And last one, check deposited and dishonor. Suppose we are check deposited 10th January, designer is 17th January. When we are departing, write to customer account amount in bank column. Amount in bank column. When they says the check is dishonored, that day you have to record on the credit side. On the credit side, by customer account amount in bank column. This is also contra entry. This is the format: date, particulars, LF number, discount allowed, cash, bank. Date, particulars, LF number, discount received, cash, bank. So this side is also three columns, this side also three columns, so it is called three column cash book. Remember one thing: all the transactions must be recorded as per the rule. When you are preparing cash column, you must remember real account principle: what comes in debit, what goes out credit. When cash is comes into business, it will be recorded in cash column debit side. When cash is going outside, and it must be recorded on credit side of the cash column. When the transactions related to bank, so bank is receiving cash or not, suppose bank is receiving cash, it must be recorded this column, amount must be recorded in bank column. Suppose bank is giving, banker is giver, so the transactions must be recorded in particular column, amount in bank column credit side. You know the, and the last one, discount allowed is the expenses, sorry, loss, so it must be recorded on the debit side. And discount received is, and profit, it must be recorded on credit side, in credit side and discount column. This is about triple column cash book. Remember one thing: in triple column cash book, record only cash transactions, either cash or through check, whatever it may be. There is no record for credit transaction, credit purchases, credit sales, and assets or goods, whatever it may be, is not record in the and triple column cash book. There is no record for outstanding expenses, there is no record for and prepaid expenses, there is no record for accrued incomes, whatever it may be. And when cash is receiving, when checks are receiving, and the transactions must be recorded in triple column cash book only. This is and about triple column cash book.